Last week we talked about buying a house with solar panels on it. This week we're going to talk about selling a house with solar panels on it. And we're going to do that right now. In this video, I'm not going to discuss whether solar panels are good or not, or the advantages of them or disadvantages. I'm going to discuss how to sell a house with solar panels on it. The absolute best way to sell a house with solar panels on it is to own them outright. The next best way is on a solar loan, then a solar lease, a power purchase agreement, or the worst way to buy solar panels and then sell the house is on a PACE loan. Now, the only way solar panels really add a lot of value to a home is if you own them outright, but they really don't. It's kind of like a pool. It makes it easier to sell to people who want a pool. It makes it easier to sell and adds a little bit of value for people who really want solar panels. A lot of times people are looking for the house and they fall in love with the house and then it happens to have solar panels on the roof. As an agent listing a house that has solar panels on it, you want to put in the description of the property the benefits of solar. You're selling not only the house, but you're selling the solar panels on top of the roof too. So you want to put in there the benefits, not just that they're solar panels. Most agents will put if they're paid for or if they're on a lease right in the description or in the agent's confidential notes. It's a good idea to have it there. Another thing that I like to do is go ahead and have the solar contract, if you can, the application for the other person to take over the loan, the lease, so that they can look at it when they're looking at the property on the MLS. As a person selling the house, you want to get a relationship with your solar power company as soon as possible. When you decide to sell the house, get online, get onto your account. Your only contact before has been to pay your bill every month or have an auto pay. And so you don't have a relationship with them beyond that. You need to start forming a relationship to find out what it's going to take for someone else to take over that lease or the loan or whatever it is that whatever way you own those panels that are on the roof, or you don't own them and you're leasing them, or there's a power purchase agreement there, you're going to have, the buyer is going to have to qualify to purchase those panels or to lease those panels that are on the roof. So you want to have that relationship and you want to have that information before you go into contract for the house, because here houses can close in 21 to 30 days. This may be a hurdle that people have to jump over and add more days to the contract unless you're all ready to go. And that's the reason, hey, you're selling the house, you probably want to get out of there. You have an advantage over the person who sold you those solar panels to begin with, because you have the actual track record for your house on how much money that saved you in your energy bill. So you can have the printout of what you pay on your energy bill every month. And everybody kind of has an idea how much savings they're getting because they know what their bill is if they don't have solar panels. So you have to sell those solar panels to some people. Some people already know, but if they're just hunting for a house and they happen to have solar on the roof, you could get the past printouts from these other companies that'll tell you what you've consumed or what those panels have produced throughout the year. Each company is going to have its own application and its own determination of who qualifies to take over the loan, and you want to get on that right away, almost immediately. If your realtor will probably know something about dealing with solar power companies. The other realtor on the other side, on the buyer side, is going to need to know some things too. And if they don't, your realtor is going to have to teach them real quick. They've got to get on the phone real quick or on their computer. Computer's always best with these companies. They're into tech. So get on the computer and get that application done and get them thinking about whether this person's capable of taking over their loan. They're going to do a credit check just like any other person that's taken over that much responsibility are handing over that much responsibility to the new buyer. Some people recommend buying out the lease when you sell your house. It depends on how bad you want to sell your house, in my opinion. The thing is that the buyer of your house is going to get the benefit of those panels in the future. So you're done with them. So buying out the lease is a good idea. It sure makes it easier to sell your house. So it depends on which market you're in. If you're in a buyer's market, you'll probably want to buy out the lease so you can get that sale completed. Otherwise, you want the buyer to assume the cost of those panels because they're going to have the future benefit of the panels. As an agent, I want to have the contract that you signed. If you don't have it, you know, in a physical thing, you can download it as a PDF from your solar provider. I want to have a few months, or at least, well, the best is 12 months worth of performance. I want to have all that information so that I can present that to the buyer in a way that makes sense, and so they can see exactly what they're getting into. So there it is. It's really pretty darn simple. Have your contract, have your performance laid out. There's not a whole lot of maintenance, so you don't really have to have. If you do have a maintenance schedule, that would be neat to have. Have all the details already ready. Your realtor will put it in the MLS as additional documents and things like that for agents to take a look at and present to their buyers.